record. I'm going to mute everyone just in case everyone isn't muted. And then we're all going to start to connect with the breath. Moving to our bolsters, if you have a bolster. If you do not have a bolster, that's completely fine as well. Please don't worry about that. Breathing in to a four count, holding to a four count, and exhaling to a four count. And again, Heidi, who's just joining us, we are going to hopefully at the end of the practice be moving to a wall. So if you have a wall that you can put your legs up on and move your mat to that later on, not now, I'll give you time to do that. That would be wonderful. Maybe start thinking about it. Again, breathing into a four count, holding to a four count, and exhaling to a four count. And as you breathe, breathe in through the belly, up through the ribs, the lungs, all the way to the tops of your throats. And then exhale in the opposite direction, from the tops of your throats down through the ribs, the lungs, all the way to your bellies, as though you're wringing water from a washcloth, bringing navel into spine. I must say, I have a friend whose husband seems to be showing symptoms of COVID, and so I asked another friend for all of the natural remedies. So I was just sending that as I was going through that meditation. If anyone else needs that, what happened to my music? If anyone else needs those different things that are very, very effective, please let me know and I will forward it to everyone. As we breathe in, again, find where there's any type of resistance or unhappiness in the body. As we breathe out, breathe that resistance out. And let's begin. Inhale, two, three, four, hold. Two, three, four, and exhale. Two, three, four. Again, inhale. Two, three, four. Hold. Two, three, four, and exhale. Two, one more time, inhale, two, three, four, hold, two, three, four, and exhale, two, three, four. Now allow your breathing to come naturally to its own rhythm. Allow the warmth of your breath to go to any area of your body that is tense or sore. And allow the breath to relieve the tension or soreness that is there. Imagine your breath gathering up all of the tension and soreness in your bodies and breathing it out so that you begin to feel peaceful and relaxed. Any distracting thoughts or feelings that you may have, allow them to allow them to be sent out with the breath. And as you breathe, allow yourselves to go deeper and deeper into this state of calm, knowing that you are in control at all times. For all of you who are a part of Helping Parents Heal, I just want to let you know that Irene is concerned about Tony, who is feeling ill this morning. And I know that you all, just as much as for me, want her and Tony to be safe. So as we set our intention today, let's keep Tony and Irene in our thoughts as we practice. Again, set your intention for this practice. It could be physical, mental, or spiritual. And it could be for you or for someone you love. Seal that intention with one deep inhale. And one deep exhale. Thank you all. Inhale those knees and arms to center. Exhale as you roll over onto the right side in the fetal position and remain here for a few breaths. Good job. Let's go ahead and remove those bolsters from behind us. We're going to stay on our backs. Roll back over. If you have a block underneath your head, put it off to the side. Inhale as you draw those knees in for a hug. Sorry, worse today. And then exhale as you place your feet on the mat. Good job. Inhale as you place those hands around that left thigh, interlace your fingers. Exhale as you extend that leg, flex your foot, draw those shoulders back and down. And breathe. Again, your breath is your power. Keeping your hip down as much as possible. If this is in your practice, maybe grab onto those toes. Drag that leg down even closer if you can. Don't feel like you have to. Just go to wherever is comfortable for you this morning. And again, here in Arizona, it's been fairly cold, so it's a little more difficult to open up. Especially if you're walking between the casita and the house. And smile. Again, I know that 2021 is going to be easier. Irene and I have already been talking about starting to plan in early 2021 for a conference in 2022. We're so excited about it. We can't stand it. Let's take two more deep breaths here, in and out. And then slowly inhale first, release that right hand down. Exhale as you allow that left leg to fall open with gravity. Now, since you have your bolsters and your blocks, you may want to put a block underneath that thigh
could also put your block under there. Make sure that you're comfortable as possible in yin, obviously. Should be slightly uncomfortable just because of the fact that we're opening that fascia. And breathe, breathing in and out. As we breathe in, find where there's resistance in the body. As we breathe out, we breathe that resistance out. And again, if your right hip is popping up, you've gone too far. Try to keep that right hip down as much as possible. Let's take two more deep breaths here, in and out. And slowly inhale as you draw that leg to center. Grab on with your right hand. Allow that left hand to fall down. Extend that right leg. Inhale first. Exhale as you allow that left leg to fall over to the right as much as possible. And again, try to keep that left hip down as much as possible. Of course, on this side, it's impossible to keep it all the way down, but we're trying to keep our hips as parallel as possible to the ceiling, to the mat. Breathing in and out. Again, you're welcome to use props. You can place that bolster underneath your thigh or your calf if that's more comfortable for you. And breathe. So, just to let you know, we're trying very hard to figure out good Christmas movies to watch during the time that Michael and Evix are here. So, our choice was Blades of Glory last night, just because of the fact that it was one of the movies that the kids loved when they were younger, especially Morgan. Boy, is that a silly movie, but it is so funny and so uplifting. So, kind of gross. There's a lot of gross out moments, but it's still very cute. Let's take two more deep breaths here, in and out. Namaste. and slowly inhale. As you draw that left leg to center, exhale as you draw those knees in, give yourself a hug, rock back and forth. Anyway, please think of all your favorite Christmas and holiday movies that you have been watching. And maybe you can tell me at the end of the recording what you think. Sorry, I have to mute everyone. Place both feet on the mat. Interlace your fingers behind that right thigh. Inhale first. Exhale as you open up that leg. Flex your ankle. Draw those shoulders back and down. Breathing in. Again, if this is in your practice, you can grab onto those toes and drag that leg down even closer, keeping those hips on the mat as much as possible. And again, in Yin Yoga, it's always important to realize that it should feel uncomfortable because that means that you're making progress, but it should never, ever be painful. If there's any pain, pull out. You can do it next time. Let's take two more deep breaths here, in and out. Then slowly inhale. As you release that left hand down, exhale as you allow that right leg to fall open with gravity as far as you can, keeping that left hip down, breathing in and out. Let's take two more deep breaths here, in and out. Then slowly inhale as you draw that right leg to center. Extend that left leg, grab on with your left hand, release that right hand down, and exhale down to the left as far as you can, but keep that right hip down, breathing in and out. Thank you. Let's take two more deep breaths here, in and out. Slowly inhale all the way back to center. Exhale as you draw those knees in from rock back and forth. Good job, everyone. Let's go ahead and place our feet as wide as the mat. Arms are out east and west. Inhale first. Exhale down all the way to the left. This time, place that left foot on top of your right knee if this is in your practice, and look off to the right side in windshield wipers. Breathing in and out. Opening those hips as much as possible again. One of the most important things that we can do in yoga is to open those hips. These hips are so important later in life. Keeping us balanced, keeping our hips from becoming brittle. Again, releasing lots and lots of unwanted emotions that we store in those hips. And smile. I'm so happy to be on here with you. And again, I feel so much optimism for the first time. I feel like with this vaccine, we're all going to be in a yoga room again, doing yoga together. And maybe I can even do modifications to people, which will be so exciting at some point. Not immediately, but it's coming. Slowly release that left foot. Inhale those knees up. And then exhale down to the right. Place that right foot on top of your left knee. Look off to the left and breathe. Slowly release that right foot. Inhale those knees back to center. Draw them in from hug. We're going for the threesome. We're doing all of these today. These are big, deep stretch exercises. They're not exactly yin, but they are very, very important. Inhale first. Exhale as you extend that left leg. Inhale as you grab on to that right calf. Exhale as you draw it in. Flex both feet, shoulders back and down. Inhale out. Exhale, draw it in. Shoulders back and down. Always remember in yoga, no matter what you're doing, you're drawing those shoulders back and down. Inhale out. Exhale all the way down. And we're almost always flexing our feet unless we're in candlestick with Barbie feet. Inhale out, that right arm comes up overhead. ahead and exhale as we push that right knee over to the left. Now we're going to go a little bit further today, unless you don't want to. It's okay if you don't. Inhale first. Exhale, bend that left knee. Grab onto your left ankle if this is in your practice. Inhale first. Exhale as you extend that right leg. You can hold on underneath your thigh, your knee, your calf. Or maybe grab onto your toes. Flatten out your backs. This is a little bit more intensive. Again, you can go to whatever position feels comfortable to you. Two more deep breaths here. Then slowly inhale as you draw those knees to center. Excuse me. Exhale as you extend that right leg. Inhale as you place your hands around that left calf. Exhale, draw it in. Flex those feet, shoulders back and down. Inhale out. Exhale, draw it in. Shoulders back and down. Flex those feet. Inhale out. Exhale, draw it in. Inhale out. That left arm comes up overhead. Exhale as you push that left knee over to the right. Inhale first. Exhale as you bend that right knee, grabbing onto your right ankle. If this is in your practice, don't feel like you have to. I don't have a lot of room here, but I can come back. Inhale first. Exhale as you extend that left leg, holding on to wherever you can, flattening out your backs. This is a deep stretch. If any of this is painful to you, just go to a lower level. You're fine wherever you are. Slowly inhale as you draw those knees back to center. Exhale, extend those legs below you. So let's go ahead and move into infinity pose. Roll over onto the right, left side, left elbow, left palm of your hand down. I apologize for my voice today. This is hard to listen to. Inhale as you bend that right knee, grabbing onto your right instep. Exhale, extend above you, drag that right shoulder back and down in infinity pose. This should be a little easier than normal right now because we've already done a lot of deep stretching. So with that muscle memory, it should be feel a bit easier than normal. If that's the case, maybe even grab on to that calf and drag that leg towards you. Maybe rotate that ankle, keeping it healthy. Now then from here, inhale that knee to center. Exhale, extend below you. Pull over onto the right side, right elbow, right palm of your hand down. Inhale that left knee in. Grab your instep. Exhale, extend above you. Again, dragging that left shoulder back and down. And this time, again, you might feel that you can move that leg even closer to you by grabbing onto your calf, pulling it in, maybe even rotating that ankle back and forth. Inhale that left knee in, exhale, extend in front of you. Roll over onto your backs. Place your hands behind your thighs. Spinal rolls from shoulder to tailbone and back again, allowing each vertebrae to come back into alignment. Good job, everyone. So we'll do three or four of these and arrive at the tops of our mats in Sukhasana, simple seated pose. Let's work on our shoulders just a bit today. And again, I'm sorry my hair is, I haven't straightened my hair yet, so it's all over the place. But anyway, let's go ahead and inhale that right arm all the way up. Exhale as you place your hand behind your back. Inhale that left arm up, grab your elbow, and exhale over to the left. Looking up towards the ceiling, opening up that right shoulder, breathing in and out. Again, this is the Tibetan chakra opener. Inhale, both arms up. Exhale down. Inhale that left arm up. Bend your elbow as you exhale. Inhale that right arm up. Grab that left elbow and drag it over as much as you can to the right, looking up towards the ceiling. Opening up that left shoulder this time. Breathing in and out. And smile. It's a beautiful day today. Inhale, both arms up. Exhale down. Good job. And then from here, let's go ahead and place our hands on the mat and roll up into table. Let's do a few cat-cows to open up that spine. Starting in table, our shoulders are above our wrists, our hips are above our knees, and if we look between our legs, we shouldn't see our feet. Inhale first, the cow. Look up towards the ceiling. Drag those spines down as much as you can. Open them up as you do. Exhale. The cat dragging those spines all the way up, gazing at our navels. Inhale. The cow. Exhale. The cat, drag those spines up, gaze at your navels. One last time, inhale. The cow. And exhale. The cat, good job. Come back to a flat back and then place your toes together, knees as wide as the mat. Inhale first, exhale. As you draw your hips back towards your heels, walk those hands out. Drag your chin or your third eye down towards the mat. If it's your third eye, maybe massage it, rocking back and forth, opening it up. Breathing in and out. Then slowly inhale as you come back. And then let's go ahead and curl our toes under. Sit back on your heels. Place the crowns of your heads on the mat and grab onto the soles of your feet, pulling yourselves in for rabbit. Breathing in and out. Slowly release that left hand and then the right. Come back up to table. Turn your toes under so that you're actually on the tops of your feet. And we're going to rotate so that we can turn our mats so that they're facing the wall. We're going to be doing legs up the wall from now on. If you don't have a wall, that's also okay. You can actually do legs up the wall by just holding on to the backs of your thighs. You don't have to necessarily be on a wall. Make sure that your bolster is in the middle of your mat, if you'd like, so that it's more comfortable. And keep your block handy. Again, get up the wall. We place our hips and our knees up against the wall on either side. And then slowly exhale. As we twist towards the wall, scooch those elbows in as much as you can. This is a position that allows our circulation to come back down to our vital organs, back down to our brains. Again, it keeps us from having varicose veins, keeps us beautiful. It's a natural facelift. Always important to do this because it relaxes us naturally. It's something that allows us to sleep at night by doing legs up the wall before you go to bed. Breathing in and out. And legs up the wall. Let's take two more deep breaths here with our legs up the wall. Then slowly inhale. Exhale as you allow those legs to fall open with gravity in dragonfly as far as you can. I have a statue on one side. Again, breathing in and out. I know we've all tried dragonfly sitting up on the floor. This is so much gentler, but it's something that very, very important to do. Ooh. we're here for 3 minutes, so allow that fascia to open, breathing in and out. You feel that you have made any space to move into, do so now, maybe allowing those legs to come out a little bit farther. I don't have any room on my left side, so I think I'll stay here. Possibly you can press on those thighs, drawing that tailbone down as much as possible to get a deeper stretch. Let's take 2 more deep breaths here, in and out. Then slowly inhale as you drag those legs to center. Exhale, placing the soles of our feet together, dragging those blades of your feet down the wall into Baddha Konasana. Pushing those knees towards the wall, maybe pressing on your thighs. I don't know how many of you have tried to go to the post office. I've been 3 times in the last maybe 5 days, and the line goes all the way back to the back door in our Cave Creek post office, and I'm not going to wait. Everybody has masks on in a very small space for that long. The line goes fairly quickly because everyone is socially distanced. So obviously it's a lot quicker than you expect it to be, but it's still a little bit disconcerting to have so many people in a small space like that. Take 2 more deep breaths here, in and out. And slowly inhale as you extend those legs up. Exhale as you cross that left, that right ankle just below your left knee, pressing on that right knee. You can also bend that left knee and drag the sole of your left foot down the wall, pressing on that right knee as much as possible, breathing in and out. Resting pigeon, opening up that right hip, releasing any unwanted emotion that you may be storing there. And again, with that muscle memory, this might be just a little easier than normal. Drawing those shoulders back and down as much as you can as you're doing this. And again, it's normal. If your hip starts shaking, that means that the resistance is leaving the body, your fascia is opening. Take two more deep breaths here, in and out. Then slowly inhale as you extend those legs. Exhale as you bend that left knee, crossing that left ankle just below your right knee, maybe pressing on that left knee with your hands. And then possibly bend that right knee, drag the sole of your right foot down the wall into resting pigeon. Again, this is our inclined version. Opening up that left hip, releasing any unwanted emotion that you're storing there. Breathing in and out, consciously dragging those shoulders down towards the mat as much as possible. And I'm so excited to be able to be doing this with all of you every morning. It just makes me so happy that we're all together doing this, keeping ourselves healthy. Again, we're here for a few more minutes. Just settle in, allowing that fascia to open. If you're trembling, if that left hip is trembling, do not worry. That's a good sign. Let's take two more deep breaths here, in and out. And slowly inhale as you extend those legs up one last time. Exhale as you draw them in for a much deserved hug, rock back and forth. Now for our Shavasana, we're going to go ahead and first of all, inhale through your nose's side out, inhale. One more time, inhale. And then extend your legs up the wall one last time. We're starting, we're finishing our practice with legs up the wall in Shavasana. Arms are down beside our torso, palms are up to receive down to ground, starting to relax. Relax your toes, relax your feet, relax your ankles. Relax your calves, relax your knees, relax your thighs. Relax your hips, relax your torsos, relax your fingers. Relax your hands, relax your wrists, relax your forearms. Relax your elbows, relax your upper arms, relax your shoulders. Relax your necks, relax your jaws, relax your cheeks. Relax your foreheads, relax the crowns of your heads, just relax. Start to bring movement back to your fingers and your toes by wiggling your toes and maybe touching each finger with your thumb. Reach your arms overhead, extend through your feet, giving yourselves a full body stretch, filling your lungs with your breath. And exhale as you draw those knees in for one final compassionate hug, rocking back and forth, massaging your lower backs and your kidneys. Slowly roll over to the right side in the fetal position and remain here for a few breaths. Then using the strength of your arms, come back to a seated position, facing the front of the room. Legs are crossed, hands are at Anjali Mudra. Heads are bowed in honor of your practices. From the place deep in my soul that I know to be pure and true, I bow to and honor that same place that resides within each of you. Thank you so much for coming to practice yoga with me on this beautiful Tuesday. Have a wonderful rest of the week, and I'll see you tomorrow. Namaste. Shanti, shanti, shanti. Thank you, everyone. So glad you were here.
Thank you, Elizabeth.
And if you have suggestions for Chris or holiday movies, then let me know. I'm always interested to know. And